Hello everyone, myself Sumit Baldia, Assistant Professor, Scherer Institute of Technology, College of Engineering. Today we are going to study about psychrometry, which is coming under Applied Thermodynamics 2 subject, and also in the chapter of refrigeration and air conditioning. Today we will cover the 3 points under the psychrometry: what is psychrometry, properties of psychrometry, and psychrometric processes. Psychrometry plays a very important role in the air conditioning system. Previously, under human comfort, we are only considering the temperature and the purity of air. But later on, we are again interested to go for the humidity check. And afterwards, we found that so many people are not feeling comfort with respect to temperature only. So we are heading towards the psychrometry chapters, which is nothing but a study of moist air. Here, psychrometry is a science dealing with the physical laws of air-water vapor mixture. What is the percentage of moisture in the air that we need to calculate? When designing an air conditioning system, the temperature and moisture content is very important to produce the desired air conditioning effect. In other words, we can say that psychrometry is a study of moist air or moisture of dry air and water vapor. There are lots of properties of psychrometry, such as dew point temperature, relative humidity, humidity ratio, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, humidity, again under humidity, specific humidity and absolute humidity, and then last one is psychrometry ratio. First we will go through the dew point temperature. What is dew point temperature? The temperature at which the moisture starts to condense out of the air is known as. You know the example of mirror in the morning itself. On the vehicle's mirror, the dew is deposited on the mirror of it. So that is, we can go for the temperature, condensing temperature of the air, that is nothing but dew point temperature. Dew point is also known as saturation temperature. Dew point temperature is determined by moving from the state point horizontal to the left along lines of constant humidity ratio under the upper curve saturation temperature boundary is reached. So dew point temperature is nothing but a temperature at which moisture starts to condense out of the air. Here you can see the figure of the dew which is flowing around the leaf of a particular plant. So condensation occurs at the dew point temperature. Next parameter or property we can call as relative humidity. Relative humidity is very much important in the designing of air conditioning system because it will decide a content of moisture in the air in terms of percentage. Here the relative humidity is defined as, it is the ratio of amount of moisture that a given amount of air is holding to the amount of moisture that a given amount of air can hold. Okay, so here the two figures are there. One drop, if 50% RH, more moisture will be there, that will be covered, or that will be nothing but 100% relative humidity. What is humidity ratio? Humidity ratio is actual weight of moisture present in 1 kg of dry air. Okay. So it will be defined as W. It is expressed in W, which is nothing but M divided by G. M is nothing but actual weight of water in the air, and G is nothing but a unit mass of dry air. Next parameter is dry bulb temperature. Dry bulb temperature is our normal thermometer which measures the temperature of surrounding. So it defined as the temperature indicated by a thermometer exposed to the air in a place sheltered from direct solar radiation. The term dry bulb is customarily added to the temperature to distinguish it from wet bulb and dew point temperature. So dry bulb temperature is used to measure the temperature of a dry air by our normal thermometer. Okay. Next is wet bulb thermometer. In order to know the temperature of moisture present in the air, you need to go for a wet bulb temperature. Wet bulb temperature is nothing but a moisture temperature recorded by the thermometer when the bulb is enveloped by cotton wick saturated with the water. The accuracy of simple wet bulb thermometer depends on how fast air passes over the bulb and how well the thermometer is shielded from the radiant temperature of its surrounding. So dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperatures gives you the relative humidity. If dry bulb temperature is 23 degrees Celsius, wet bulb temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, we'll get the relative humidity is around 60%. So that we are going to calculate later with respect to dry bulb and wet bulb temperature. So these are two thermometers which will measure the dry bulb, and bottom thermometer will measure the wet bulb temperature by using the wick which covered the bulb at the bottom of the thermometer, which is now measured. It is measured in Fahrenheit. So there are lots of psychrometric processes are used in order to design air conditioning system. In that, there are total 6 processes are there: sensible heating, sensible cooling, humidification, dehumidification, adiabatic cooling, and adiabatic mixing. Here, if we consider the example of Rajasthan, there the temperature is too high and the humidity is very low. So in order to feel comfort, you need to increase the moisture content in the air by humidification process. So one of the psychrometric process is humidification. Okay, so where we can do the dehumidification process? In the area located near Mumbai or Goa area where the humidity is very high, you need to decrease the humidity level in order to feel the comfort zone. Okay, so that these parameters are very much important in order to design an air conditioning system. Sensible heating means you are increasing the temperature without change in its specific humidity. Sensible cooling is you are decreasing the temperature without the change in specific humidity. Okay, so adiabatic cooling or adiabatic mixing means heating and humidification, heating and dehumidification, cooling and humidification, and cooling and dehumidification. These 4 processes are coming under these 2 categories. So heating and humidification means we need to do heat as well as humidification. For example, Kashmir or European countries, they are following this process, that is heating and humidification. Heating and dehumidification, similarly in winter areas, European countries, Kashmir, there also if the humidity level is high, you need to decrease it. If the humidity level is higher, lower one, you need to increase it. So like that, you need to go for a particular process in order to design air conditioning system. Cooling and humidification and cooling and dehumidification. Cooling and humidification we are doing in the Rajasthan area. We need to cool the air as well as we need to humidify the air. So we need to go for both these processes in order to feel the comfort. Okay, and cooling and dehumidification, that means in Goa area we need to cool the air and as well as we need to dehumidify the air in order to reduce the moisture content from the air. So these are the psychrometric processes. It is very much important while designing the air conditioning for a particular areas. Here we are going to stop about psychrometric terms and psychrometric things. In the next lecture, we'll go further about the types of power plants which are used.